Good afternoon, everyone. So I welcome you all once again on the final occasion for this foundation event, GSFC University. And especially, I welcome Mr. Deepak Meghani, who is going to deliver his valuable speech to you people. Mr. Deepak Meghani joined Indian Police Service after passing Civil Services Examination 2009, conducted by UPSC. He did his foundation course at Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, Missouri, and basic professional course at Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel National Police Academy, Hyderabad, and was allocated Gujarat cadre. Prior to his joining IPF, he was a faculty at SPIPA, Ahmedabad, and some other private institutions for coaching general studies, public administration, history, geography, English. He had cleared many state level and central level competitive examinations before finally joining IPS. Though he has done his graduation in physics, he is fond of reading literature and humanities. His collection of poems, Titiksha, was published in 2017. Running, movies, lawn tennis are his other interests besides reading and writing. Currently, he is posted as Deputy Commissioner of Police, Zone 1, Vadodara City. He also writes blogs such as Parivrakshaya, View Chakravihu, Salaunted Space, and on the deepakmeghani.wordpress.com from time to time. Amongst many personalities who have molded his life and character, the name of Swami Vivekananda is prominent. He has been reading Swami Vivekananda and related books since his school days, and he is ardent believer in Vedanta philosophy. So with this, I invite Mr. Deepak Meghani to deliver his thoughts to our younger masterminds. So, you'll be needing
fine. Good afternoon, friends.
Good afternoon, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine.
This portion is fine. This portion is not fine. How are you? Great, thank you. Well, after so many days I'm speaking in front of students. Last lecture was in MS University in 2020, in the month of February. And since then, we all are facing this pandemic situation. My topic is values and ethics. Ma'am asked me whether I'm going to speak on anything. It has been always my one of the values that I never use any paper while speaking. This is also value. The value and ethics. There are so many hues and colors. Just a minute. Huh? There is some situation going on. Just a minute. I have been told that you have just joined the university, you are actually in the initial phase of your career, and you might be facing many other dilemmas, many other questions, many other queries, or many other thinking patterns, some dilly-dallying also going on, how to do, how to go ahead in life. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
We have come this far, but now what? Where we are going and how we are proceeding? What is success? What is failure? What is achievement? What is happiness? What is the importance of family life? What can I do as an individual? What can I do as a citizen of this great nation? Where do we stand? And where do we stand vis-a-vis IITs and IIMs? Where do we stand in the competition? You might be hearing again and again, this, the world is full of competition, there is cutthroat competition, even a single job you have to fight to the nail. Okay? This all phases we have been through. I have been through, we people have been through. So my initial part, I will stick to the concepts of values and ethics, how they are important, their significance, and in the later part of this lecture, we will interact. That would be better. You might be having many questions. You might be having many queries to ask. You can freely ask me. Many times it happens that people don't ask any question, though there are questions. You right now also so many thinking is going on in your mind. I want to ask this question, and you might be swallowing your larva. You might be thinking what to do, what he will think. So first thing about value is, don't think what others are thinking. This is first value that I follow. Don't think much what others are thinking. First of all, think about yourself. First of all, think about what you want. Sit with yourself. Talk to yourself. Give yourself some freedom. What you want. And most of the time, if you sit with yourself, your problems will automatically start shedding, start living. You people might have heard the name of Blaise Pascal, a very great revolutionary in his times, a scientist, a kind of scientist, a kind of laureate also. He said that most of the problems of humankind, of the world, can be resolved if a person sits just for half an hour calmly alone. And when you sit like that, automatically problems start dissipating. So one thing, one value, which the most important value which as a young person we should imbibe is, don't think much about society. Don't think much about the world around. Don't think what they are thinking actually. Think, be careful, be environment friendly, be courteous to seniors, be courteous to elders, listen to them, but don't allow the society to ride on you. We always say, sabse bada rog, kya kahenge? Log. My mother used to say, when I was very young, suno sabki, karo man ki. Sabko suno. Suno sabki. Karo man ki. Listen to all, but follow what you believe is true, what you believe is the most positive thing. So one thing is this, these are values. Many other values are there. And again, before I delve further into this values and ethics concept, let me very much be specifically mention what is the difference between values and ethics. Can anybody tell? How do you see ethics? How do you see values? Anybody? Try, it's okay. If you don't try, you are certainly fool. If you are trying, you may be fool, you may not be fool. Koi bolega? Hindi mein, Gujarati mein. Values and ethics. Values and mulya. Ethics and niti. Niti matta. Haan, please. Yeah.
Ethics is what is generally overall good for the society. Like what is beneficial, what is right for the society. And value is a very much individual choice. Like what you will live is to be right or wrong. So I think value is personal, yes. And ethics is personal.
Great, thank you very much. Ethics actually precedes law. Ethics precedes law. Law kya kehta hai? Law kehta hai? किसी को चीट मत करो, If you do cheating, you will be behind the bars under IPC 420. And cheating. If you do forgery, if you are a fraudster, if you tease a girl, if you stalk a girl, if you are very strict, you will be behind the bars. This is law. If you violate the Motor Vehicle Act rules, you will be penalized. You will be punished. Sometimes you may be punished by a jail term or sometimes by fine. Okay? This is law. Law says this Domestic Violence Act, Dowry Prevention Act, Indian Penal Code, etc. These are laws. Ethics means, in one line if I say, ethics means good of all. Good of all. And do unto others what you want yourself to be done with. Ethics is like morality. Ethics is bedrock of all the religions. You add Hinduism, you see Hinduism, you see Islam, you see Christianity, Judaism. You have summary of all the religions, and in one line if you want to summarize, it is jaisa log aapke saath karna chahe, jaisa aap log ke saath karo. Be good, people will be good. So do like what you want to be done with. So this is ethics. Mainly this is the power of ethics. Now, for example, if you happen to be in bus, there will be some reserved seats in bus, reserved for women or reserved for handicapped people. Okay? There are some seats which are reserved for women and women are sitting on it. Four seats are reserved for women and four women are sitting on it. But there is one male standing in the bus, he is not having a seat. That male is suffering from fever, that male is weak, that male is 90 years old. So ethics says the seats are reserved for women. Why should they give? Why should they give their seat to that male? Because seats are reserved for women. I am woman, I am sitting. But the male, other women are strong, young, robust. And that male, he is having the tag that male are supposed to be strong, but male who is 90 year old, male who is suffering from some ailment. So ethically the women are not committing any wrong. Are they committing?
No.
No. Ethically they are not right. Legally these women are not committing anything wrong. Legally they are okay. They have paid the price. They have paid the price. They have paid the fare. And they are sitting on the chair. Okay, sit. So they are legally, they are right. Ethically, are they right?
No.
No, they are not right ethically, though the seat is reserved for women. This is ethics. Because they are not good. That goodness is lacking. This is what ethics is. Ethics is common sense. You don't need to learn or read so many books for ethics. If you think and if you feel from your heart how you should behave, that's what ethics is. How you should behave with others, that's what courtesy, or what we say, maintaining decorum, courtesy, using parliamentary language, using proper language, not to abuse anybody, not to hurt somebody's feelings. This is what ethics is. A professor teaching ethics ditches his wife. Legally, he takes divorce from his wife. A professor ditches his wife and then legally takes divorce. Is he legally right or wrong?
Right.
Legally right. Ethically?
Wrong.
Because it ditched, I am using the word ditch. If it is out of mutual convenience, mutual respect for privacy or mutual respect for another, there are other situations, number of situations, then it's okay. But you ditch somebody and then you go for it. Legally you are right. You applied for divorce in the court of law. You took the divorce. Legally you are right. You have done no legal violation. But you are not right ethically. There are n number of hypotheses in this situation. But you have to always think, what is ethical and what is legal? And the more advanced society is, the more hiatus, the bigger hiatus between ethical and legal is going to be. More. What you have to keep in mind is that do unto others what you expected to be done with yourself. That's it. Don't hurt anybody's feelings unnecessarily. Never, never, never hurt. This is what Jainism is all about. This is what Buddhism is all about. This is what all religion, all the spiritualism all about. And if you are true to yourself in that way, you are ethical. You are not supposed to read books. If you read books, good. But if you think that ethics can be taught, then we are mistaken. Ethics can't be taught. Yes, one is ready to learn, then can be taught. But ethics you can't impinge upon. You can't just impose ethics on somebody. A bad will be bad. Bad will be bad person. Howsoever teaching, howsoever preaching you do. Gujarati ma kahiye chhe, bhens agar bhagwat. It is not possible. You can't just explain, you can't just teach, you know, go on. Anyway, so these are the things we have to accept. What are values? See, I am an ethical person, you are an ethical person, you are an ethical person, you are an ethical person. We all are ethical person. Suppose, my ethics, your ethics might be many times similar, same. But my values and your values may be altogether different, diabolically apart. My values might be totally different, your values might be totally different. See, again, during our freedom struggle, our freedom fighter, Subhash Chandra Bose, he went to Russia, he went to Japan, he went to many other countries for seeking the help. And now this Japan, Russia, these countries are right now not portrayed in a good way. Japan was actually, you know, Japan faced nuclear attack, Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So was Subhash Chandra Bose back? No, he was not back. His values were very clear that he wants to serve the motherland, he wants to help our motherland. Try to understand. Values of Warren Buffett and values of Harshad Mehta might be different. Though they were in the same sector, they are in the same sector. Harshad Mehta was also there in the share market. Warren Buffett is there in the share market. In one profession, one doctor, suppose medicine is there. Two batchmates are there. Both are MD physician, both are cardiologists. But they have different values. One decides that he wants to serve the rural area, the underprivileged people, the people who are not getting proper treatment, and he charges very less fee, 10 rupees per patient. And as many OPDs as he can do. Sometimes he even doesn't charge 10 rupees. He doesn't charge any rupees, any fees, extra fees for emergency. Anybody who knocks at the door at 2 o'clock, he is ready, he is smiling. He is always smiling. He is serving the people. He says, here I am to serve. These are his values. And there is another doctor. He says, no, forget about rural, I don't want to work in urban India also. I want to apply the visa for visa and I want to go to United States or any other better developed country in the world. I want to go and work there, shift wise I will work there. No, if somebody comes, if hospital calls me in emergency time, extra fees, extra dollars will be taken. I will be having big mansion, I will be having limousines, I will be having 3 to 4 yards, I will have my charter plane, I will have this family, that family. These are his values. I am not saying the values are bad. Values are different. He also doing service to the nation because he is paying tax after all. He is paying tax. Through tax he is serving the nation. So values define us. Your percentage won't define you. Right now, generally we think after 12th standard or after graduation, people do ask. Even people in matrimony also ask. Dasma ma kila taka aya? Barwa ma kila taka aya? Come away. In matrimony, I have seen people asking questions to the particularly bride, would-be bride. Kila taka aya? Taka, और टैलेंट का टैलेंट में कोई संबंध नहीं. The values are going to define. Can you tell me how many percent did Mahatma Gandhi got in 10 standard? Can you tell me anybody?
33.
12 standard? Or can you tell me Rabindranath Tagore, how was he in studies? Rabindranath Tagore, there were, I think 10 kids in the family. In their family, there used to be tradition that once in a year they used to get together. And then they used to write about the description of each child. So Rabindranath Tagore's brother would write, elder brother, his uncle would write something about him, his aunt would write something about him. They used to write, Mera pehla bachcha achcha hai, tisra achcha hai, tisra achcha hai, chautha achcha hai. Aathwa kuch nahi karega. Our eighth kid in the family, you want to do anything, we will have to save money for him. We will have to give him palm so he can do rustic activities. That is, he was Rabindranath Tagore. Ek pitcher ki khiladi thi shayad. Usme ek comedian hai, Johnny Walker, kya naam hai uska tha, Johnny Lever. Woh kehta ki mera pehla bachcha ye vakil banega. Toh kyun vakil banega? Jhoot bolta hai bahut. Dusra bachcha ye patrakar banega. Ki baat ko bada chada ke kehta hai. I don't exactly remember. तीसरा बच्चा क्या बनेगा? ये पॉलिटिशियन बनेगा. ये बहुत वादे करता है, प्रॉमिसेस आफ्टर प्रॉमिसेस. ये बच्चा क्या बनेगा? ये बनेगा. तो ये कुछ नहीं करेगा, ये बहुत सीधा है. आखिरी बच्चा ये कुछ नहीं करेगा, ये मेरी तरह नारियल तोड़ेगा. सो रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर फैमिली, दे यूज्ड टू हैव दिस ट्रेडिशन एंड दे यूज्ड टू हैव डिप्लोरेबल कंडीशन, पुअर किड, कुछ याद नहीं रहता. बिकॉज ही यूज्ड टू स्टेयर, ही यूज्ड टू लुक एट द स्काई, ही यूज्ड टू लुक एट द बटरफ्लाइज, बर्ड्स, ही यूज्ड टू थिंक इन हिज ओन वे एंड ही यूज्ड टू राइट हिज ओन लैंग्वेज. ही वॉज लॉस्ट मेनी टाइम्स. पीपल डोंट, ही इज नॉट रैशनल, ही इज नॉट कोहरेंट. गॉड सेव हिम. देन व्हाट हैपेंड? पीपल हु वर डिस्कार्डेड, द पीपल हु वर कंसिडर्ड टू बी deadwoods, they rose. Have you thought that had Mahatma Gandhi been successful in India as a lawyer, would he have gone to South Africa?
No.
He failed here. He himself has told in his autobiography, he couldn't succeed much. When the litigation was going on, he used to doze off. You might be dozing off right now. Some of you might have taken very good sumptuous meal, delicious. You can doze off, it's okay, it's your freedom. But Mahatma Gandhi, he couldn't succeed here as he wanted to, and he went, that's why he went to South Africa to be defense lawyer of some other parties, and there he defined his values. Values define you. Percentages won't define you. You are handsome, stud. Sometimes you know classmates say, "Yar, saaf, yar, stud lage chahiye. Tu to yar stud lage chahiye. Ekdam. So style hai tari. So hairstyle chahiye. Nawa chashma ni frame lage ho. Nawo jeans lage ho. Levi's mo lage ho. Nawo mobile phone lage ho. Hai na? These things don't define you. Believe me. These things don't define you. Your values define you. Your percentages, your memory, your handwriting. It's okay if it is, you have good percentage, it's okay. Great, you must have. Good handwriting, you must have. You are able to speak properly, you have got gift of the gab, you can express your thoughts in a very coherent and cogent manner. Great, you are gifted child. Good. But this can't be the yardstick of your inner character. Character is everything. And character is built by values. And values are something that you have to go to the mountain and choose yourself. If I give you values, that you have these values, then those values are dematajan. Those values have no values. No value. No value. It's bargain, basement price. No. You have to choose each and every. It's like, you know, Thanos, Endgame.
Yes.
What does he do? He collects the stone. How many stones he collects?
Five
or six?
Six.
Anyway, आप देख लेना Endgame is good movie. Endgame is a good movie. Endgame or even Infinity War, you will come to know. I am not answering you here. He collects the stones himself. Am I right?
Yes.
Consider values are like stones that you have to collect, and they are going to give you superpower. Superpower to make your own destiny, to carve out your own path. But that you have to collect yourself. And Thanos, his stones may be taken by Avengers. Your stones won't be taken by anybody. Once, if they are in your hands, if you have got it imbibed in yourselves, nobody is going to take those values out of you. And they will define your life. They will define your each and every moment. And Chandrakant Bakshi has been a great author in Gujarati. He is considered as one of the best authors in Gujarati literature. His one quote is very good. Mulyo ni taka jabardast taka. Jivan mein jare kahi na hoy, kashuj na hoy, chare taraf khud andhkar hoy, tyare mulyo tamne je chhe jivad se jitad se. Values, when you have nothing. And you will be, you know, though you have nothing, but you have got values. Swami Vivekananda, when he went to United States, he had nothing. He was sent by some students, some disciples, some followers who gathered money for him, bought ticket for him, sent him in a steamer with one reference like the World Religion Congress is going to be there. He went there. He reached there in the month of July 1993. The conference was in the month of September. What did he do for 2 months? In railway stations, in other corridors, in other roads, he was just moving here and there, sometimes without food, sometimes without any shelter, in the winter of those times. After he delivered his first speech, then the world gradually began to, you know, move around. There were many other religious leaders from India in Chicago. But why Swami Vivekananda? Swami Vivekananda was, it is said, he was one of the last person to speak. And when he was going to speak, while he was coming from the LA, he was shivering. He himself has said, he was shivering because that was his first speech at the age of 30 years. And see, this is the history. Because he had values. He had very much clear, defined, very much crystal clear values. What I want out of my life and what I want to do with my life. That is going to decide. Out of these gates when you graduate, out of these gates when you pass out, it is good to have good percentages. But if you are just focusing on good percentile, good percentages, or having good academic record, then you are missing woods for the trees. Okay? I hope the differentiation between ethics, law and values, I am successful enough to explain it to you. One artist, he died at the age of 95. Till the age of 95, he was in the profession of creation, in the profession of painting. On his deathbed, when somebody asked, what is the most significant value that you have always had in your life? He said, honest expression. This was his value. Whatever he saw, whatever he felt, he painted. You should have something of your own. That doesn't mean just to go for vocabulary building or just to go for some adjectives, no. Or some Latin words, Greek words to define yourself, no. You should feel it. Feel it as if they are the part of your body. Feel it as if they are the part of your own conscience. inbuilt in your character. You can make it. And values are moving point. Values are your anchors. Values are your wings. They may take you anywhere, any places. Well, these are basic things, basic ideas that I have spoken about. And if now we interact, if we deal with some questions, that would be eventful.
Okay. What happens if we don't have values and ethics in our lives?
Chaos. Nirav Modi is there. Hai na? Vijay Mallya is there. Charles Subraj, he was also there. Hitler was there. They might be successful in their individual fields. Hitler was a great leader at that time. The people of Germany, well-educated, intellectual people, you Audi, BMW, Mercedes, these are cars from Germany. The people of Germany are very much intelligent in the field of science. They elected him. He was elected leader. He was not somebody who was just parachute leader. He was elected by the people. Do you think he had values? Everybody has values. Then here come positive values and negative values. He had one that dream that not even a single Jew I want to see. To him, this was a very holy dream that Germany should be got rid of, pulsed with the Jews. Nirav Modi is living a very lavish life. I have seen from the newspaper reports. Vijay Mallya, he was 5 years ago, he was on calendars. His calendars were sold like anything. Am I right? His beer was sold. People used to go and see his mansion in Goa. Do you believe he had values?
No.
He might be having values, but values, if they shift, they are not values. If values, and what is the benefit of values? If forget about others, I am not able to create my own good image in front of me. Imagine, you have the whole world with you, but you know what you have compromised. You have the whole world. Whole world is speaking very much positive about you. Newspapers are speaking just like anything. TV channels are hankering here and there for having your interviews. You are considered as a very charismatic leader, successful leader, go-getter, die-hard, and a result-oriented, one who delivers. That kind of image you are having, but you know that you have sold your soul. I think that's not value. You can be successful, you can fake, you can cheat so many people. Some fool all of the world some of the time, some of the world all of the time, not all of the world all of the time. You may succeed, but at what cost? There are so many incidents when the world was against them, but they said, no, we will go. He had the learning disability. His teacher to his mother, your Tommy is not able to learn. And his mother, forget, I will graduate, who once upon a time was discarded, was not considered as a good boy, was considered to be a very, okay, he will not do anything in his life. You may breathe. You may have vegetative condition of the soul. Vegetative condition means, it's just going on. You are breathing. Saans lena, or le lo, bachche paida kar lo, shaadi kar lo, byah kar lo, do char gaadiyan ho jaye. बहुत सफलता पाल भी हो, सब कुछ हो जाए, आपके नाम की यूनिवर्सिटी हो, कल को हो सकता है ना, बट क्या ये दुनिया अगर मिलती जाए तो क्या है, ऐसे का कोई मतलब नहीं है। आई डोंट थिंक सो ये सक्सेस है, टू मी इट इज नॉट सक्सेस। और व्हेन यू हैव यू नो व्हेन यू हैव वैल्यूज नो यू विल आइडेंटिफाई, यू विल नो लाइक अ मैग्नेट विल नो हु इज मैग्नेट, एन आयन विच इज मैग्नेटिक विल नो विच इज मैग्नेटिक। इफ यू हैव गॉट हाई वैल्यूज नो nonsensical elements will automatically get rid, you will go away because your purpose is very much clear. Yes, you should not develop ego. Ego to the extent that you protect your own identity is okay, but I am something better than other people, that's ego, that's a harmful ego. Lord Buddha used to say that ego, ahankar hona hi chahiye na, ego you should have because ultimately you are in body, you are there. If suppose I ask you what is your name, you say naam mein kya rakha hai, you have name, that is your identity, that is your individuality, so that much ego is there. If I ask Pankaj khada ho, to koi bole kaun Pankaj, kaun Arvind, kaun Saroj, sab maya hai, naam to maa baap ne rakh diya, chhodo is baat ko, theek hai aa gaye nahi, इतना तो आइडेंटिटी होता है कि क्लास में चार या पांच पंकज होंगे, वो खड़े होंगे, सर मैं पंकज, पंकज कौन सा, ये सेल्फ, दिस इज सेल्फ, दिस मच सेल्फनेस शुड बी देयर, है ना। लेकिन पंकज ही सबसे अच्छा है, क्या प्रकाश ही सबसे अच्छा लड़का है, बाकी सब लड़के बकवास है, गधे हैं, उसमें ही समझदारी है, ये ईगो। So, values you should have, ethics you should have, something you should have, and they define your character. And you know, character is very difficult to make. Swami Vivekananda used to say, you give me 100 Nachiketas, I will transform the nation. So, character is something very, character is not that you get a certificate that we know this person is a good character, that is different character. That character means you have not done any crime, which has been reported. You might have done crime, but it might have gone unreported. You have not done any crime which has been reported in the records. So that's why we are giving you certificate that okay, you are of a good character. It is presumed that you have good character. That is different character. That is legal character. You might be given visa, you might be given Padma Shri, you might be given any other awards. But you know where you stand. You know. Your soul knows. Your integrity, that should be very, very impeccable. I know, I'm telling you, it's very difficult. It's very, very difficult. To preach is very easy. But yes, something I have of my own life, I can tell you. When I appeared in UPSC interview, Union Public Service Commission interview of this IPS examination. And, you know, there are many myths going on. How to prepare for UPSC examination, how to appear in interview, etc. I was coach in SPIPA, I was coach in many other institutes. I had a brief rush. I never went to Delhi in my life. I went there for interview. Well, in mains examination form, you have to write down your hobbies and what you are doing. Mains examination form used to be 10 pages at that time, in our times. My mother's name, my mother's birthplace, my father's name, my father's birthplace, his income, my siblings, anybody in the service or not, my own history, my own work experience, everything you have to jot down. So that was a column of hobbies / interests. My friends used to say, I have very few friends. So two or three friends, they say, mar jayega, mat likh. My hobbies are reading. It's very, very much clear. Oh, I remember I had 7 hobbies listed over there. Reading, meditation, music, watching movies, chess, graphology, and poetry. So these 7 hobbies I listed out. People say, reading? Thakur to give. Ek movie thi na, concert Karan Arjun. Usme wo keh rahe Thakur to give. Reading? Tu to give. Thakur to Deepak to give. Meditation? Yaar tu kya leke aate? Music? Bola ye hai. Then what you do? I said, this is my pay scale and I am coach here in this is my visiting faculty charges, or this is what I am getting, what my monthly income, this is etc, my yearly income around. You say, this is suicide machine. And I had one value very much clear. I don't want to lie. I am teaching public administration, why should I lie? And I am teaching to the same people category. By luck or by bad luck, I began to earn very fast because I come from middle class and I wanted to be self-dependent, and the values of my relatives and parents were not matching with my values. The values, they wanted me to be abroad. I wanted to be in UPSC, in civil services. So values were separate, so I decided that I will rebel and I will fun on my own. So that's why this trajectory of teaching started. If I'm earning, I have to do something. I mentioned this, the ambis. And I got 240 out of 300, one of the highest marks. In UPSC history, I think 240 out of 300 is considered very good. Highest. They said, I think might be highest. You got it. You stick to it. You lie and you get success, there is no point. But you stick to it. You stick to it and with. But yes, you should claim it. You just can't fake it. People will catch you. People will catch you. If you are faking it, people will catch you. So be true. And see, I am having a reading hobby. It doesn't mean that I have read all the books of the world. No. But you ask me the books which I have read, whatever thousand number of books I have read, I can speak on them. If I am interested in music, doesn't mean that I know all the singers. Pop, jazz, classical, non-classical, folk, not necessary. So whatever life I have lived, whatever music role music has played, I can speak about it. I don't want to be a classical singer, I don't want to know etc. each and everything. But this is my common sense. One of my friends, he was asked in interview that what is the size of football? He was a football player. He said, sir, I don't remember the diameter. Today, you are a national player, you should know the size of football. He said, this much. This much. He succeeded. Yeah, football ke itna hai na, main to itne se khelta hun. I don't know, main inch ke bhi thodi baithunga. No problem.
Hello. Sir, good afternoon sir, I am Kushata from B.Tech Chemical Engineering. Sir, मैंने आपके लिए दो लाइन लिखी है कि पुलिस वालों की जिंदगी का भी अलग फसाना है, तीर भी चलाना है और परिंदे को भी बचाना है.
हाँ.
तो सर, उसमें से मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि सर, आप दोनों को मैनेज कैसे करते हो?
हम तो तीर नहीं चलाते, लाठी चलाते. बंदूक चलाने का अवसर बहुत रेयर में मिलता है. बहुत दंगा हो, बहुत ऐसा हो तो टीयर गैस वगैरह होता है, लाठी होती है, रबर बुलेट होती है, और फिर ओरिजिनल बुलेट का तो मौका नहीं आता. ऐसी कुछ टेरिटरी हो तो होता है. हाँ, ये आप बोल रहे हैं मैनेज, क्या मैनेज करना
सर? कोई भी मतलब दो सिचुएशन हो, मतलब आप इधर भी जाना है और उधर भी जाना है आपको, तो वो मतलब आप मैनेज कैसे करते हो?
दैट विच इज टेकिंग द लार्जर, दैट विच इज फॉर द लार्जर बेनिफिट ऑफ सोसाइटी. और जो सही हो, सब कुछ तो नहीं आता. यू कांट हैव एवरीथिंग इन योर लाइफ. एंड इफ यू वांट टू बी रिच, डोंट जॉइन गवर्नमेंट सर्विस. इफ यू वांट टू बी रिच, इफ यू वांट टू हैव सो मच यू नो बेनिफिट्स, मटेरियल बेनिफिट्स, डोंट जॉइन गवर्नमेंट सर्विस. And if you are so much, you know, fond of good postings, you can't have principles. You can't have values, principles, if you are fond of good postings, cream postings, so-called, you know, that kind of thing. So, my values are very much clear. I am very much clear what my values are. And that I have come to know after so much hardship, so much struggle, so much failures, so much rejections. Then I have come to know these are my values. This, here I stand. Maybe after 5 years, my values will be stronger. One or two or three or four values, more values I will be having. But whatever I am having, I am not going to lose them. I am going to consolidate them one by one. So my values are clear. When it is matching with me, then it's okay. Now if my value is, suppose I want money, I want money, then my values are not strong. So when your fundamentals are clear, everything is manageable. Everything is manageable. Yes. everything. You can manage your family life, your personal life, your private life, your public life, everything can be managed. You have to be just true to yourself. Gujarati man kahiye chhe chhas levani to dhoni na santara hai. Chhas bhi levi, aapko karna bhi hai aur chupana bhi hai. Aap dono nahi, duniya mein sab kuch, we all are living in glass houses. We all are living in glass houses. You can hide something today, not forever. It will be visible. Do sawal aur. Yes.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Smith Sona from BTech CSE. Sir, my question is not related to value and ethics, but it's related to something law. Sir, what happens when in a single case, two sections or two, you can say, laws are in front of each other?
Contradictory.
Contradiction?
Yes, sir.
For example,
Shreya Singhal versus Union of India.
Okay.
That Balsaheb Thackeray case in which a girl was arrested.
भाई कोई रिकॉर्ड तो नहीं कर रहा ना?
लाइव हो रहा है।
The law is very much objective, but sometimes there are subjective interpretations, and that's why courts are there. When it is understood that, or it is believed that police has misused the law or wrongly applied the sections of law, any party can approach the higher courts and can get the justice. It is okay. Sometimes it happens. It happens. And sometimes the things are not as they are perceived. And sometimes the things are much harsher than the way they are perceived. So, in the national interest, police acts actually. I would not like to comment much upon this thing. Hai na? And otherwise, you can meet me in private. Yes.
Sir, I would like to ask that this hall is full of people and everybody is having different values. So I want to ask that keep all the people aside. Suppose I am having a thing like a value, but how can I find it is good or bad for me?
You know.
Sir, but how?
Juta pehen ke hoga?
Haan.
Juta pehen ke pata chalta aa raha hai ki nahi aa raha.
Thank
you. You know. Have you heard Margaret Thatcher, England's Prime Minister?
Yes.
Have you heard her name?
Yes.
She used to say one very good quotation, that is her very good statement. So being a leader is like being a lady. Being a leader is like being a lady. If you have to tell the people that you are not. So if you are something, it is visible. Your values. अब जैसे आपको आपने कुछ खाना खाया जबरदस्ती खाया और लोग बोले कैसा लगा तो आप अगर बहुत बड़े कलाकार हो तो पता नहीं चलेगा, एक्टिंग आप कर लोगे, अदरवाइज पता चल जाता है इसको अच्छा लगा या नहीं लगा. तो यू कम टू हार्ट, आपका हार्ट आपको दिल में बैठ जाता है कि नहीं ये सही है ये गलत है. यू नो इट वेरी वेल. कानून वगैरह बाकी जो चीज़ें लोग जो कहते हो, लेकिन इट इज़ वेरी मच क्लियर कि आपको सही है, हाँ ये सही है गलत है, ये भाई तुमने सही नहीं किया है ना. आप कहे गए किसी होटल में, वेटर को आपने बहुत गंदी तरह से बताया, ऑर्डर किया गंदी तरह से, उसके साथ बिहेव किया, एम आई राइट? शायद आपने शायद उसको अपशब्दों से नहीं नवाजा, आपने उसको गाली नहीं, लेकिन योर बिहेवियर विथ हिम इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड इज गुड. तो समबडी सिटिंग विथ यू विल फील ये तुम अच्छा बिहेव कर सकते थे, तुम्हारा क्या जाता है, वेटर क्या कर सकता है तुम्हारा, तुम्हारी लाइफ में क्या नुकसान कर सकता है. यू माइट हैव बीन मोर कर्टियस, मोर सिविल. सो इट्स लाइक दैट. यू कम टू नो यस. एंड इट्स लाइक यू हैव टू सी, यू टेक वन वैल्यू, ट्राई फॉर 5 days, 6 days, 10 days. Value is not like diet. People go for dieting, no? Vegan diet, keto diet, paleo diet. If this diet is not suitable to me, this diet is suitable to me. Value is something very much intangible. But still you can try. And when you try, when you think about it, you will come to know how much it suits you. It will suit you. Next, yes.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Preet Gujar. I am from BBA Business Analytics. Sir, my question is, there is a rumor in the society or there is a talk that for clearing UPSC, you must study for 18 hours or more than 18 hours. But a specific condition for a person is for just to 6 hours. So is it true that a person studies for 18 hours to clear a UPSC examination?
The great source who have told you so, you should jot down their names. Psychologically, is it possible?
No, sir.
Psychologically, it is not possible to read 18 hours a day. And if you read for 18 hours a day, then you don't need to clear UPSC. You need to be sent to the lab and you need to be experimented upon. There is something in your brain, which is not normal. Maybe tomorrow's examination I may read for 18 hours, 20 hours. See, any branch of learning which takes away your sleep is not good. Even when I was preparing, I had this saga heard. When we were preparing in college days, there used to be so many stories. One person succeeded in UPSC examination and unfortunately he was chain smoker. So the people around found, by smoking cigarette you get success? They used to smoke. And one person said, I had taken this pledge that unless and until I clear UPSC examination, I won't be having hair on my head. He counseled his head. So after he succeeded, he got success. His neighbors also had counseled heads. This logic don't work. People have so many myths. People who are having high percentages, only they can clear UPSC examination. People who are coming from urban background, people who are very good in English, people who are having very good height and physics, only they can become IPS officers. Okay, people who have good mugging power, mugging skills, only they can. People who are in social, people who have somebody in family, people who have somebody in the society, only who have access, etc. So many myths are there. It is not so. 6 to 8 hours per day, consistently for 2 to 3 years. If that much you can do, nobody can make you fail. But it should be in a proper direction. It should be in proper direction. Suppose when your parents come and they feel that you are reading Indian Constitution. And once your parents go, do you read Manohar Kahaniya? Then no. Then no. Reading is okay. I have seen many people, they start reading at 11 o'clock at night. Before that, they just gossip here and there. And then their parents say, my son is burning midnight oil. Six to eight hours focused, dedicated study. Not so many books, sufficient number of good books, proper books, it's okay. This much you can do. And you are not supposed to be very high in that kind of capacity. I have seen people, normal graduates with normal percentages, they clear, and very well they clear. People from IGNU also clear. People from Baba Sahib Ambedkar Open University, those who have graduated from there, IGNU graduates, they clear this examination. It's your way of preparation that is more important than number of hours. I will take last question. Yes.
Sir, what was the reason to become a civil servant and how was your experience in Surendranagar when you were posted as a SP?
See, I come from rural area and I am a millennial. So, rural area, millennial. My school, I have studied in that school where we used to wear uniform once in a year when inspection was supposed to be. There, teacher was supposed to, bada saab aayega, then we used to do this. We were told that you have to do this. There were some boys and girls who never used to take bath. So teacher used to tell them, take bath and come. I'm from that school, and we didn't have classroom. We didn't have classroom in my school. There were classroom A, B, C. A and B used to have classroom. A means very good boys, rich boys. B means middle, and C means those teachers felt that these people are strugglers. I was kept there to make the average set. So I come from those. I used to see ambassadors, white ambassadors, sometimes coming in my village, and this curiosity I had. What is that? And very spick and span, very clean white ambassadors. So then curiosity started. I began to ask my elders, what is this vehicle for? Why they are having this light, etc. It was charm. From urban, if you are from rural area, it has its own charm. So that was there, and after my higher secondary education, during my higher secondary education, somehow this thing got percolated down in me. I want to do this. I could have done many other branches like medicine, engineering, etc. But I wanted to be graduate as soon as possible. And this was a challenge to me. Challenge to me, why? Because I am from Gujarati medium basically. My primary and higher secondary education happened in Gujarati medium. And many times I was teased and I was taunted by other fellows during my colleges also that you are from Gujarati medium, you don't know anything, etc. So I had taken it as a challenge that I will appear in UPSC examination in English medium. I will prove to you. So that was personal also. I wanted to settle the score. And I wanted to do something different. Something different, which nobody in my class was thinking. When I was in college, people were thinking about MBA, MCA and going abroad. I was preparing for the civil service examination. I used to prepare for this. I was even also called bookworm during my college days. I never used to mingle. Not that much mingle. Anyway, so this was, I wanted to do something different, something better. Aisa nahi ki duniya badal dunga. लोग बोलते हैं कि नहीं मैं तो पाप को जलाकर राख कर दूंगा आगे देखता हूं मैं आता हूं लोग हैं पीपल हैव दिस थिंकिंग नहीं मैं चार्टर सिस्टम को पूरा बदल दूंगा नो दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंकिंग एटलीस्ट इतना समझदारी तो ठीक है बट यस आई वांटेड टू बी इन दिस कैरियर यस आई वांट टू बी अ सिविल सर्वेंट आई वांट टू सी द सोसाइटी फ्रॉम वेरी क्लोज क्वार्टर्स आई वांट टू सी द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हाउ द थिंग्स वर्क एंड व्हाट डज इट टेक टू बी अ प्रॉपर गुड इंडियन सिटीजन What our Indian constitution says, these values I had, something I want to do different. So with that notion I entered. Surinagar was a good tenure, good full 25 months tenure. And I always have held my ground wherever I have worked. So there also I used to hold my ground and it was good. Surinagar again is one of the best districts to work because it's one of the biggest, 10,000 something square kilometer. It's as big as Tripura, Manipur, this kind of states. And 10 talukas, different rajwadas. This year, here you have Thangad, there you have Lakhtar, then you have Dasara, Patadi. One side you have desert also, one side you have got hilly areas. Good experience. Criss-cross here and there. Sometimes I used to travel 350 kilometers in a day to tackle the situation here and there. Caste composition wise also, it is very much variegated. Very much variety is there. And you get to learn so many things. It was good experience. Yes, I am running short of time. I have a meeting at 4:30 at Police Bhavan, but I will speak in brief. I will not. I don't want to do any injustice. Please.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I wanted to ask one question. Is it true that in Indian Police Service, IRB is very strictly being followed?
Indian Police Service.
Hierarchy is strictly being followed.
Yes, hierarchy is followed. The police actually has come from military. Hana? Police has come from military, like from a head constable is senior to constable. After head constable comes ASI, then comes sub-inspector, then comes inspector, then comes deputy SP, then comes SP. My rank is of SP rank. In city we are called DCPs. Then comes SSP, then comes DIG, then comes IG. The rank has to be followed because we are a discipline organization. Police is a discipline organization. Yeah. So rank, hierarchy is strictly followed. Strictly followed. That doesn't mean that we don't talk. We do talk, but with proper decorum, proper respect, and a proper protocol is maintained. Thank you. Last question, please.
Sir,
Sir, what is your message for today's generation?
No message. Why do I'm not Masiya. I'm not Guru. I don't want to be Guru Bhai. I'm just a normal human being. That's it. And you be normal too.